Hey everyone, happy Friday. So I have been doing all of my live videos and live streams and all this stuff for work today. So I figured that I would come into this very important group as I have NMO and share something with you. So I think I've commented before, but I figured I'd just come in live. So I have decided to share my story about NMO, having NMO, and everything that I've been through the last year on my YouTube channel. So I will post that link in the comments when I'm done with this video. Typical hiccups every time I do a live or record my podcast. So annoying. Comment below if you love having the hiccups. Anyway, so I decided that I have NMO. Why not just tell the world and help raise more awareness and share my story so that maybe I can help other people, right? So that's what I decided to do. And so I've had a lot of stuff in private mode, but I decided the other day, well, I think it was a couple weeks ago, that I would publish everything publicly. So I chose to do that. And also, if you feel like following along, I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel. And I'll put that, hi Monica, I will put the link to my channel in the comments. And also, because I really like to stay as positive as possible, but I have to like seriously vent about two things, which you guys are the only ones that can actually relate to when I share this story. So I don't know how many of you are getting Rituxan or if you've had it. I've read some stories that it does wonders for your teeth, as in it really destructs your teeth. So long story short, I have to get all this major dental work done, and it's probably because of Rituxan, but who knows, maybe it's not. It's just, I've been reading, I'm so itchy. Oh my God, I don't know why. I've been reading a lot of stories about this, and so I feel like, I'm just going to blame that. But here's my little vent. So actually a couple of you have been posting about this since I went to the dentist. And we need to get a medical clearance as well as a pre-med with major dental work is what I'm being told. So it's taken, I'm looking at my planner. 4.5 weeks. For my neurology team, which I love, used to love, I still do love them because they actually gave me the right diagnosis. So yes, I do love them. Fourth neurology team. And they keep sending piles, well, basically my whole medical record to my dentist when all the dentist needs is, will you clear her for this surgery? Does she need a pre-med? So now on the 26th, my dentist has to have a conference call with my neurologist just to get me cleared. It's like insane. So as you guys know who are watching this or watch the replay, that this is like our job, that we don't get paid. Like there really needs to be like some law. Like if you work X amount of hours trying to save your own life, that you should start getting paid. Because I've worked like 40 hours a week over the last year and a half, 2 hours, just trying to save my own life because there's so many people. And if you want to, you know, be proactive and get answers, like you have to fight like hell and like get stuff done. And that means you have to constantly make the decisions yourself. So, anyway, so that's like my first rant. It's taken like, it's going to be 5 weeks. It's on the 26th. That's, yeah, 5 weeks to get an answer. All of my dental appointments that were scheduled every single week are now getting rescheduled, which is like a pain in the butt because I'm super OCD and I have a major highlighting system in my planner. And when I have to cross something off and reschedule it, I'm like super annoyed. Anyway, the second rant is my port. I don't know how many of you have ports, and I asked this question the other day in the group. So my Rituxan is now twice a year, and I was in the hospital for 9 days and had 13 or 14 IVs. I think it was 14. And sorry, my eyes are killing me right now because I've been doing lives all day. So my veins are like invisible. So of course I have a port. And it hurt like hell. Anyway, we all have to get our ports flushed, right? If we're not using them. So guess who's calling to make that happen? Like, why doesn't anybody, like the nurses, the doctors, the medical assistants, like why aren't they calling us to schedule our port flush? I don't understand. Like, I'm literally doing this all the time. Like, you know, I have like serious chemo brain. I'm forgetting so much lately. I have to write everything down. And what if like I really like completely forgot for like 3 months? What's going to happen? Nobody's called me to remind me about my flush. It's probably clogged. I'm going to have that awful procedure to get it in and out again or whatever the case may be. But that's not our job. Like, we're not the medical assistant. I don't understand. I just went on and on about this like on a Facebook Live on my Just For Us community page. And then I'll put it on YouTube later, but that's not our job. Like, why can't these people get paid money and we're doing it for free? So anyway, I have to schedule my port flush myself to get it flushed and then get the approval so that I can get this damn thing out. Because I'd love to know, most of you said that you've taken them out. I'm just over it. I fly a lot, and even at Downtown Disney the other day in LA, I had to go through, get like the legit like pat down, like rub down, because I couldn't go through their metal detector, and I had to give them like this whole story and like literally show them my port. Like, it's so ridiculous. Hi, Mary Lou. So, like I'm at Disney and I'm like, I have a port, it's not a gun. And I'm like, I getting chemo treatments and that's why I haven't. They're like, oh, you look so great. And I'm like, just stupid people. That's my third rant. People are so stupid. Like, don't open your mouth if you don't know what to say or like what's going on. Anyway, so that's that. So, I would love to know if you guys have, your ports out and if you feel like a million bucks, because I'm so sick of mine and I feel like it's hurting me now. It's like, it's not bruised, but I feel like I can see it more, but it's like more swollen. So I don't know. I'm just over having a port is the moral of my story. But I just wanted to come in and say hi and know that you guys are amazing because we're all in this together and one day there will be a cure. And I try so hard to stay positive. This week honestly sucked. Like, I was super depressed and I had 2 panic attacks. And I woke up this morning and I tried to like get my shit together. I hope I can swear on Facebook Live. I try not to, but sometimes I do. And luckily nothing's got deleted, but I'm going to continue to share my NMO journey on my YouTube channel. And, you know, a lot of people say your business is online. Like, everything you do is digital and online. Like, you really want to like tell the world that, you know, you have this autoimmune disease. And I said, hell yeah, I do, because there's no cure. You think I want to have Rituxan for the rest of my life? I've lost half my hair because of that. I've had to like chop it off and it just keeps continuing to fall out. Now my like neuro-ophthalmologist is saying I have thyroid eye disease, which let me know if any of you guys have had that. It feels like it's bruised here like so bad, and my eyes actually really hurt right now because I'm constantly like staring at the camera. But your eyelids are super puffy, and I have Hashimoto's as well, so obviously like thyroid is like so common. But here come my hiccups again. That is something else I'm dealing with now. He says it's not my vision. It's not the NMO. He thinks I have thyroid eye disease now. So now I have to go get a CT scan of my eyeballs. Was only diagnosed. Shelby, I can't read the bottom. But yeah, having an autoimmune disease sucks. And I've also started another Facebook group called the KK Cafe, which all my friends call me KK, and my kitchen the KK Cafe. And a couple of you from this group are actually in there. But I'm trying really hard to eat a lot of vegetarian dishes and vegan and just like a lot healthier, because it makes such a big difference not having dairy or soy or meat sometimes when you're suffering with autoimmune diseases. So I'm trying really hard to eat like that. But I just ate bread and pasta. So, you know, there's always a cheat day. So if you guys want to join that group, I'm sharing a ton of recipes. I do a live cooking show. It's just something that I love to do. I have about like 10 recipes I need to put out this weekend. But if you love cooking, I'd love for you to join us. But just if you guys are having like the worst day ever, just know that there's so many of us that are in the same position. And just think about each other, like how to keep each other positive and how to, you know, we always hope that there's a cure. And, you know, I saw the other day that somebody had passed away and it was just like a huge trigger. Like, who's next? Like, it's not okay. Like, I see... the Guthrie Jackson Foundation, you know, they're having this like roundtable discussion, and there's so many people that are posting on Instagram because I live on Instagram for work, and I'm like, okay, that's great. Like, when is it going to happen? Like, I don't want to be on drugs for the rest of my life. Like, I just want to, you know, I'm always having, I don't know about you guys, but I'll have such a good week. And then, like, for example, like all this dental stuff, and then the chemo comes about, and then I don't want my port, and it's like an ongoing battle. Like, I had such a good couple of weeks, and then it's like downhill, and then you're depressed and have anxiety and have panic attacks and drink a bottle of wine. I mean, that's just me. But anyway, to sum up this whole sharing journey, Facebook group rants, I wanted to, oh, I messed up my message. Sorry. She was diagnosed with lupus at 5 and has been diagnosed. Yeah, Shelby, you definitely have to stay on top of your doctors and your sister's doctors, because that's the only way that you're going to get anything to happen, basically. Sorry, my friend's dog is like super loud. Can you guys hear that? Reefy. Yeah, maybe he should be on the Facebook Live with me. Anyway, so... I will post the link to my YouTube channel if you guys want to watch any of my videos. Maybe they'll help you. I definitely don't like this in most of them. Some I'm crying, and I just don't care, because it could have hurt my business. Yes, I could lose clients. They think I'm sick, but I'm very vocal about it. So moving forward with my business, this is like what you see is what you get. Like, some days I look like shit and have my glasses on and do a Facebook Live, and other days I'm all made up and I sit in the sun too long and I have a sunburn. By the way, if you guys are on prescriptions, obviously you are, don't forget your SPF, because I'm in San Diego, not Vegas this week, and I'm so fried. I totally forgot to put my SPF on. Look at this. I mean, it actually looks a lot worse on this. I'm red, but it doesn't look as bad there. I will watch. Thank you. It's always nice enough. Oh my God, there's so many. There are thousands, Shelby. Like, I'm not even kidding. And here come the hiccups. Oh my God, I really need to get off Facebook Live. I think I'm itchy because I'm like starting to peel already. Anyway, so that's it. I'll put my YouTube channel link in the comments. And if you guys ever want to reach out, please do. And thanks for always being so positive in this group. One day there's going to be a cure. I know it. And we're all going to be rescued and laugh about this one day. That's just what I feel. Anyway, I hope you guys have an awesome weekend. It's a long weekend. I'm in sunny San Diego, not Vegas, which is where I live, but I am dying to move back here, so I'm trying to figure that out. Luckily, I'm self-employed, but I'm off to the beach shortly so that I can namaste. That's my plan. Anyway, have a great weekend. I'll see you guys all soon, and thanks for being such a great group and allowing me to come in here and do my little rant. Bye!